This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina. The practice of lynching was a phenomena of mob violence embedded in American history. The lynching of blacks has its roots in slavery and owes its existence to the post-Civil War legacy of slavery, Jim Crow segregation sanctions, and negative perceptions assigned to people of African descent. In this podcast, we examine post-enslavement lynching and the perspectives of scholars and critics. In the 1890s, journalist Ida B. Wells was a well-known anti-lynching proponent. However, other black voices were often heard on the subject. One black female critic, Mary Church Terrell, commented publicly on this extreme form of social control. Lynching was the brutal and violent practice of white mobs executing black citizens for the perceived criminal activity without due process of the law. Lynching could exceed 100 persons per year. Historians and scholars have written about the large crowds that accompanied the lynching of blacks, along with the air of public spectacle that came to be associated with the practice. After the period of Reconstruction, and particularly after 1890, lynchings of blacks significantly increased and became a popular feature in the South, an effective mechanism to keep African Americans socially ostracized, politically disenfranchised, and economically dependent. Mary Church Terrell, who was born a slave in 1863 and reared in privilege by her parents, rose to become a well-educated, middle-class black woman educator, an activist and advocate for African American and women's rights. In her lifetime, Terrell was a part of nearly every major civil rights initiative, including the NAACP, and she spearheaded developments in the black women's club movement in the United States. In her 1904 article, Lynching from a Negro's Point of View, Terrell explored the causes of lynching and the effect of the practice in the southern states. Terrell believed that there was a proliferation of common errors about lynching. One was the belief that most blacks were being lynched for the offense of rape. Terrell examined evidence similar to the earlier work of Ida B. Wells, suggesting that most blacks who were lynched were not accused or thought guilty of any kind of sexual assault. She also noted fallacies in the notion that blacks raped in order to feel equal to whites. In addition, she challenged the negative perceptions about black morality, the pathology argument that suggested that because of innate low principles, blacks as a race could not perceive that rape was morally wrong. She reminded her audience of centuries of tolerated sexual assault against enslaved black women, and how this practice was not considered rape or by law a punishable crime. Terrell explained that the charge of rape and the high incidence of lynching was a backlash of the descendants of slaveholders, a contemporary expression of vigilante hostility and racial hatred. Thus, the goal of lynching was to continue to maintain dominance over black society. Known throughout her lifetime as a tireless campaigner for civil rights, Mary Church Terrell bravely challenged Southern white women to speak out against the lynching of blacks. Her own voice denouncing lynching reminded American society that the vestiges of slavery were strong, and the act of lynching itself was, in her words, quote, the aftermath of slavery, end quote.